Israeli police investigating an explosion that killed one person and injured another in Tel Aviv Sunday. Police have confirmed the blast was caused by a bomb. It adds they are investigating all angles, but it appears to have been a terrorist attack. Local media has reported the explosion was caused by a bomb carried by the lone fatality. Now, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken now in Tel Aviv in a visit aimed at intensifying diplomatic pressure to achieve a Gaza ceasefire deal. In his 10th trip to the region since the war began in October, the top U.S. diplomat will meet with senior Israeli leaders, including Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. The mediating countries, the U.S., Qatar, and Egypt, have so far failed to narrow differences to reach an agreement. Hamas also raising fresh doubts as it accuses Netanyahu of trying to set new conditions in order to blow up the negotiations. Meanwhile, the violence continued unabated Sunday with Israeli strikes killing 21, including 6 children, according to Palestinian health authorities. Israel has denied targeting civilians as it continues to hunt down Hamas militants. Now, over in Russia, Russia denies there have been indirect talks with Ukraine on halting strikes on civilian infrastructure facilities. The Washington Post reported Sunday Moscow and Kyiv were set to send delegations to Qatar this month to negotiate a landmark agreement halting strikes on energy and power infrastructure on both sides. The Post said the agreement would have amounted to a partial ceasefire, but the talks were derailed due to Ukraine's incursion into Russia's Kursk region. Russia's foreign ministry says there was nothing to break off, while Ukraine has yet to respond to the report. Russia and Ukraine have both accused each other of striking civilian infrastructure, with both denying doing so. More than 20 people are injured after a Ferris wheel caught fire at a German music festival. The fire started on one gondola, which then spread to a second one. 4 people suffered burn injuries and 1 from a fall. Others were examined for possible smoke inhalation. The cause of the blaze has yet to be determined. The accident took place at the Highland Festival, one of the biggest rock music festivals in the region, with up to 25,000 attendees. Turning now to the U.S. campaign trail, Vice President Kamala Harris takes an indirect jab at her Republican rival Donald Trump. During a campaign stop in Pennsylvania, Harris suggested Trump is a coward whose politics focused on putting down rivals.
This campaign is about a recognition that, frankly, over the last several years, there's been this kind of perversion that has taken place, I think, which is to suggest that the measure of the strength of a leader is based on who you beat down, when what we know is the real and true measure of the strength of a leader is based on who you lift up. Yeah. That's what we see as strength. We know what strength looks like. That's what strength looks like. Anybody who's about beating down other people is a coward.
Opinion polls have shown Harris bringing fresh energy to the Democratic campaign and closing the gap with former President Trump, both nationally and in many battleground states. Over in Chicago, delegates are arriving for this week's Democratic National Convention. The event will see U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris and Minnesota Governor Tim Walz officially nominated as the party's ticket for the November election. Top Democrats, including U.S. President Joe Biden, former Presidents Barack Obama and Bill Clinton, as well as former First Ladies Michelle Obama and Hillary Clinton, are all expected to deliver speeches.
We have an amazing ticket with Vice President Kamala Harris at the top, with Governor Tim Walz, who are two people who understand the struggle of the everyday American, the working class, and will fight for them when they're elected in November.
So I certainly love Joe. I think he's been a fantastic president. I believe that he has not gotten the full credit for the accomplishments he's done in office, but I also certainly understand the feeling that we now have with a new generation stepping forward. So with Vice President Harris and Tim Walz leading the ticket, I think it's really finally showing that the Democratic Party is truly committed to being the forward-looking party. As a young Democrat, that really matters to me.
Illinois is a reliably Democratic state, voting for the Democratic candidate in every presidential election since 1992. The DNC will kick off Monday, August 19, and run until Thursday, August 22. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. Asian American community leaders and elected officials are coming together in support of a Los Angeles County proposal to give Asian Angelenos a voice when it comes to the county's government, while also cracking down on corruption. A proposal to expand the Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors from 5 members to 9 and to create an ethics commission will make it to the November ballot. Filipino community leaders believe the added board members would foster more engagement with the residents and their local governments.
There will be better service for residents. There will be more connection to the Board of Supervisors. There will be more opportunities for residents to make their voices heard.
The proposal will also create an elected county executive and an ethics commission that local elected PhilAm officials believe is needed as local governments and officials have been embroiled in controversy in recent years.
This new wave of leaders that we're going to elect will be held accountable, and then they have to be reminded that there are rules that we have to abide by. And so it's a long time coming that we've had this to have this reform.
Isn't it a little beneath you to buy a sexy outfit to make Nate jealous?
It's immature, and it's using my body for spite. Okay, I've talked myself back into it.
And finally, in entertainment news, Sam Morelos plays Nikki Velasco in the Netflix sitcom That 90s Show. The feisty and lovable character wasn't originally written as Filipino, but this changed when Morelos booked the role. In the show's Part 2, that premiered earlier this year, Morelos got to display her singing talent for the first time in the series. She jokes that aspect of her character establishes her Filipino background even more.
It was such an incredible experience because I get to use all of my, I guess, talent or knowledge and prowess. No one knew that I sang before. People on set see a different side of me than when I'm at home or when I'm like alone with my guitar and things like that. So I felt really good and really proud to be able to show that off. And it also, again, speaks to Nikki's Filipino-ness, because if she wasn't able to sing, is she really Filipino?
The 19-year-old Morelos also recently finished filming a lead role in the upcoming Hulu film Summer of 69. Part 3 of That 90s Show premieres on August 22. And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews. And head on over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.
A new alien film for sci-fi fans, a family adventure and an action comedy. Manny, the movie guy, tells us what's new in theaters and on streaming.
Welcome to the Romulus Space Station.
Set between the events of the first and second Aliens, the seventh installment in the Alien franchise takes us back to space, where no one can hear you scream.
Inspirations is all the other movies.
Director Fede Alvarez, who also co-wrote the script, finds a common ground to satisfy both fans of the first Ridley Scott film and the James Cameron sequel. Alvarez captures the haunted house in space vibe from Alien and the action-packed sci-fi adventure of Aliens.
And steal highly regulated equipment.
The result is an homage to the franchise while simultaneously moving the story forward.
In 30 minutes.
This time, a group of young space colonists discovers a derelict space station. But what they find inside is the most terrifying life form in the universe, the Xenomorph. The filmmakers follow a formula, so there are some predictability factors, but they know how to tell a scary story that will make you, well, scream. And for that, Alien Romulus gets 3 out of 4. They mostly come out at night. Kisses. Also in theaters, My Penguin Friend. Inspired by a true story of a Brazilian fisherman who rescues a lost penguin named Dindin from an oil spill. What follows next is an incredible adventure that will touch your heart.
He needs our help.
You know, very simple act that becomes like a little miracle.
Helping director David Sherman retell the miraculous story is Jean Reno. He injects his character with quiet moments of joy and redemption.
We have to take care of the earth through stories like that.
A big congrats again on my penguin friend. A penguin out of water story that's perfect for the entire family. We all need a Dindin in our lives.
It's true.
Thank you.
Is he your pet?
Not my pet. He's my friend.
And for that, my penguin friend gets 3 out of 4. The undying bond between man and animals kisses. And on Prime Video, check out Jackpot.
I realized it was hilarious and had a lot of heart and a chance to do a lot of really big action.
Bridesmaids director Paul Feig also gave us A Simple Favor and The Heat, mixes all the genres to give us this fun action comedy. It's like Bruce Lee meets The Hunger Games with a little bit of Squid Game thrown in for good measure. Set in Los Angeles 2030, after the Great Depression of 2026, according to the movie, a grand lottery has been newly established in California. But there's a catch. Kill the winner before sundown to legally claim their multi-billion dollar jackpot. Awkwafina plays that unsuspecting winner.
She's my jackpot. What is happening?
Helping her survive is John Cena, a freelance lottery protection agent.
I hope they see Jackpot and I hope they're entertained.
Plus, it works really well because you and Awkwafina have great chemistry.
You treat people like you want to be treated.
Oh, you dirt-faced me!
It's the chemistry that will charm you all the way to the end.
How's it look? Good?
Amihan?
And both Feig and Awkwafina have great things to say about our own Dali De Leon, who steals some scenes in the movie.
I first saw her in Triangle of Sadness, and she's amazing in that. And so we were like, I wonder if we could get her. And it turned out she was available and wanted to do it. So I pinch myself on the set every day because she's so talented and she's so wonderful and lovely. No, it was a real, true honor to work with Dolly.
That was so cool when she signed on. Yeah. That was like very cool.
Yeah.
And for that, Jackpot gets 3 out of 4 worth killing for kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ANC.